What's up, gardening friends? How's everybody doing? Hope y'all are doing well. I am great. Hopefully the sound of the fountain isn't too obnoxious. And today, I am spotlighting the Bikini Tini elephant ears. Now, I actually had forgotten what these were, which is the only reason I hadn't done a video on them. I couldn't remember if they were the coffee cups or if they were the teacups. And then I remember that these are a hybrid called Bikini Tini. And I believe these are from Brian's Botanicals. I'll find out for sure and put links either in the description or in the video. We'll see what kind of mood I'm in when I'm editing. I'd probably say this mound here is about 10 feet by 6 feet. And this all started from one little plant. This particular variety grows by runners, or spreads by runners, I should say. And rather aggressively. So aggressively, in fact, that you can actually kind of see the runners, these sort of long stems they come out on, growing out over onto the patio. They're not going to take root there, so it's not hurting anything. That just shows you how strong they spread. Now, some of mine are a little bit heat burnt from when we were up in the triple digits for a while. They're, you know, hanging over hot pavement, so they got a little bit cooked. That's okay. They grow so quick, I can just go through and snip those out. No problem. The growth habit on these is one of the things that's the most appealing to me. They have that upright cup to them, just kind of like the coffee cup or the teacup. They do tend to hang a little bit further forward though, and I think that in my particular situation it's because they're under this big magnolia tree, so they're reaching for the sun. If you put these in full sun, you're going to have much more of an upright, straight plant. So as far as structure goes, I wouldn't necessarily say that this is something you would plant to anchor anything, because it spreads like just absolute madness. Now, pot, however, this would be pretty cool. It's not going to go anywhere. You're probably going to have to repot it fairly often, or at least pull it out and do some root pruning to get back in. But they're super hardy. I'm in zone 6B, 6A. I'm like right on the line dividing the two. And they come back for me unprotected without skipping a beat every single year. One of the things that's really fun about these guys is how the water collects inside their foliage. If they were straight up and down, it'd just be in the middle like this little cup. And then when they get too full, falls forward and pours right out. We had a little bit of rain, so you can kind of see where that's happened inside some of these guys. Is that driving anybody else crazy? And they're easy to prune. I wouldn't typically call this a foreground plant, but I actually had these planted about 10 feet this way, and over the years they have spread. They're runners. They're just going to keep going where they want to, and they move themselves to the front. I do think I'm going to come in here at some point and kind of clean out sort of this portion, because it's blocking my azaleas and some other things. And I'm just going to let it keep going and do what it wants to do. It's fine. This area is constantly changing from the growth of the tree above it. So it makes a good filler in this particular situation. But I really think that this is an excellent plant for pot. And even more so, this is a really great plant for aquaculture. We call it aquaculture. You can grow this in your ponds. All right, and here is an example of them growing in my aquaponics pond. And you can see these guys over here are in full sun, or more sun. So they're standing up more upright. The undersides of the leaves have this awesome veining on them. And one of the reasons I like these guys in pots so much is that because when you have them up high, you can see their characteristics better. Characteristics that make them really cool, such as this black stem and these awesome black veins that run up to the leaves. I mean, look at how much detail is in there. All those veins, because the veins are all dark all the way through. It's not just the main veins. So cool and so pretty. You can expect these guys to get about probably 4 feet tall for you at the most. I've never seen them get any larger, but where I live, they do die back in the winter. Perhaps if they grow all year, maybe they'll get taller than that, but I doubt it. I know the coffee cups can reach, I think, about 5, maybe even 6 feet at its absolute maximum. But I don't think you're going to see that with these guys, because they are a hybrid between a big guy and a little guy, a big guy and a more hardy little guy, which is why they come back so well every single year. And if you live someplace where you don't think they're going to do well for you in the winter, you can just dig them up, cut the foliage back, get most of the dirt out of the root ball and store them someplace cool and dry, or you can go ahead and keep them as a house plant. But you're going to have some issues. These guys love water. They like a lot of light, a lot of water, a lot of fertilizer, which is why they do so well grown in the water. As far as flowers go, they really don't do anything that significant, but if they do flower, when they flower, it's going to come out from down below all the way down in here. And it's going to be your typical aeroid type flower. And even if the flowers are looking pretty cool, I am pretty sure that reproducing these plants is not legal, as I'm almost certain that they're copyrighted or patented, that is. So asexual reproduction is probably not allowed. But living in 6B, I'm always jumping towards any type of hardy alternative to something that gives you really nice tropical appearance, like a philodendron. Now, they don't look quite the same, but they still look pretty cool. They give us some more effect when planted in the garden, underneath trees, as long as they get enough sun. Mine aren't quite getting enough sun. Or put it in pots so that they stand out and add a nice structure within a pot, that is. Or in your garden. These guys are getting a little bit unruly for me, so like I said, I need to do some maintenance on them, but they are just so stinking cool. So if you're looking for something that has a really nice tropical appearance to it and is really, really hardy, this is probably one of my all-time recommendations. Like I said, I'm in 6B, 6A, and they come back for me flawlessly. Zero protection. The soil is kind of well-drained in this garden bed, but where I live, it's pretty much solid clay. So even where the drainage is really nice, several inches down, it's clay. If you live in Zone 5, I think this would be worth a shot, and maybe throw a bag of mulch on it just to be safe. They spread so well that if you go ahead and plant one or two of these, they will fill in an area quite quickly, assuming you give them plenty of light, plenty of water, plenty of fertilizer. Mine probably would have spread even more than they have, but they're in a part sun situation. They're getting mostly afternoon sun, and it's not a lot because this tree above them has grown so incredibly much. But when you're growing sun plants that end up not getting enough light, you can go ahead and give them tons and tons and tons of fertilizer. Not more than the recommended dosage, but just you can increase the frequency. Though when I increase frequency, I tend to reduce the dosage a little bit. That way they're getting lots of nutrients. Since they're not getting that energy from the sun, they need an extra boost from down below. All right, that's gonna do it for today's video. It was just a quick little spotlight on my bikini teenies and why I like them and why maybe you should grow them if you're looking for something tropical. But hope everybody's doing well. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you already haven't. I try and upload multiple times a week. And as always, keep on growing. Bye-bye.